5:55.
We were alerted, by a student. It's a first threat. First threat, specifically mentioned Durfee. Because if you all seen it, the second threat was even worse. But this happened Thursday night. We immediately contacted the police. We started communicating. Matt and I talked several times. And through that, we said, okay, there hasn't been a secondary threat. We looked at it, there were some other threats that happened in other parts of the country that had the same exact language and used that 100 times too as well. So it is a credible threat. We didn't turn them no. That night, Friday night, we were at the basketball game here. And you saw, we used, if you did come to the basketball game Friday night, you guys were there. We did the metal detectors coming into the basketball game. You know, we haven't done that before. We just wanted, no bags allowed. Made a decision, no bags in the gym. Put a big sign, no bags in the gym. And I think that worked well. We had a lot of positive comments from people. But while we're at the basketball game, the second threat came up. Second threat, a lot lengthier. And again, immediately started the process and spread on social media. We started the investigation, which we're still working on. It's an active investigation. I cannot comment on the specifics more than what I gave you in my letter on Friday. But the Florida police and the FBI are working in tandem to figure out who's behind this.
A logjam at our entrances with 200, 300, 400 kids waiting to get their bags checked. If you're talking about someone looking to do evil, we've just created an environment that a lot that sets it up for in terms of someone we're outside. So there's a lot to think about there.
Great question, appreciate it. So last year, we employed the metal detectors for the first time after we added a series of, bomb threat and an incident with the handgun, which turned out to be a BB gun. We employed the metal detectors. We deployed them for a period of about a month straight every day. And then we stopped. And we employed something called random, unannounced metal detectors. So we have the walkthroughs and we have the wands. And we're able, at any point in the day, anytime, we're able to wand people, which we do sometimes based on information that we may receive.
I'm not sure whose question it was.
It was Mike.
Okay. It's knowing the kids. It's having our eyes. It's having all hands on deck. It's watching kids and their body language as they enter the building. It's looking at faces and seeing if the face is the typical face that you see, or is there something different? And many, many times, we pick up on things exactly that way. In terms of monitoring throughout the day, it's, again, it's all hands on deck. It's in the hallways. It's watching, saying, well.
You want to search me? You want to check me? You want to skip me? Go ahead. But these kids with these chips on their shoulders because mommy and daddy say it's okay? No, it's not okay. It's not okay that I worry about my son coming to school every day. It's not okay that I got a daughter in Henry Ward that's petrified of going now, who doesn't know what it's like to do a lockdown or a shelter in place because they haven't done any. And I've had two that have graduated from Diamond, and I've had no problem. My son chose Durfee. Okay, but can we make everybody choose Durfee? Not because they want to come here and see who's going to fight who or who's going to do what. My niece had a chair thrown out of her in the cafeteria.
Building, they're gone. I only ask this because I'm a proud graduate of Durfee, 1991. And Officer Phillips was here at the time. And we couldn't do anything without him being honest. I swear sometimes he had BoJack on me and strolled somewhere because no matter where I was, he was. So I just find it so laxy-daisy that people can just come in and out at any time.
Who are going to do something to the school or to anywhere are going to randomly do it whenever they feel like it also. So when you catch these people, whoever is doing it behind it, you guys have protocols that you have to do, like Ms. Moore said.
Catch people made first?
Yes. So that you're going to suspend them. You suspend them for 10 days or whatever it may be.
We're talking about fights.
Well, whatever it may be.
Right, when we, hold me real quick. I'm not going to let you know what we're going to impose. We do have culprits that are proven, but we will use it to the full extent of the law.
A student here, and the day the thing happened, he told me, you know why I told you, and I want to come to this country. And I felt so bad, and I don't know how to explain to him to not feel scared to come to school. It's happened, you guys did the things Friday, but what, like she said, I hope it's not okay, you guys wait until something's happened to do the check
back, right.
Everything.
I mean, as I said, we're taking a proactive response.
Goes there, another child goes to Sylvia. So I won't lie, it was the first time I was like, oh my goodness, when I saw the first threat, we're neighbors. I'm gonna go to work, but do I let my daughter go to school? Don't I? All night I was going back and forth. Had a couple of other friends, felt the same way. We have to do it, we have to send them to school. But all night I was waiting for an email from work, from the schools, something saying that we know there's a threat and it's at Durfee, we're right next door. They were scared ahead of time to bring their kids in, and I had other parents, friends of mine that were kind of broken down, like, is there anybody going to be at Spencer Borden? Kind of just keeping an eye, and if there is, are they going to stay there? A lot of parents weren't aware of anything, that there was going to be somebody there.
Even the uniform policy, I came from New Bedford, where we had no uniform, where we have no uniform policy for the schools. And about eight years ago, there was a big thing about bringing it into the schools in New Bedford, and the parents were definitely against it. When it comes to kids, basically, when you put the rules in place sometimes, they have no choice but to follow them. But then,
sure that we do all we can to make your kids experience an enjoyable one in our school so they learn, get what they need, and go on to be successful in a place that's healthy, caring, and compassionate. You know, believe me, the teachers that we have in the system are outstanding.